Jesus, protect the bean. All right, so last night we didn't get a lot of sleep due to we allowed the dogs to sleep with us. Yeah, that won't happen again because Veda, like, and Daisy, they just want to snuggle with you, and I have to have it really cold to sleep. It was definitely a little warm, but we have a fan in here, and these sheets are good for winter, but I'm used to having the bedroom like 64 degrees at night, so it definitely was not that. So I had a hard time sleeping, but I'll adjust when it gets winter time, or closer to winter time, and cools off outside at night. It should be easier to fall asleep for me. So you're probably wondering why I need it so cold. I don't know. Like, my body temperature at night needs help dropping so I can fall asleep. So yeah, we've already ate breakfast this morning, and the doggies have ate, and we are about to do cleanup. So this is our setup for cleanup for the moment. Well, this is a shakedown, so so what we're gonna do is we're gonna use this sink that's part of the trailer to rinse, so we don't put any like nastiness down inside the gray water part. And here's the little port for the gray water to come out. So you want to always use biodegradable soap. But we got this. This is where all the dirty dishes go. And we just put some biodegradable soap in here as well. Wash, rinse in that other sink, and then dry. So we made a little clothesline right here. It was a little windy last night, so it definitely needed to be a little tighter, but again, this is just a shakedown, so as our first outing with this trailer, we are finding out things that we need, and a lot of little things, like when you think about camping, you never think about you need a paperclip, but, so, yeah, we needed a paperclip for the paper towels, because the wind was blowing, and it was blowing the paper towels off the roll. I'll show you the roll. So right there, so I created something with a nail. I used a nail and I just bent it. I bent it and just kind of stuck it on the paper towel so it'll hold it, so we can keep the galley open. But like little things like that, you never think of while you're camping that you might need. I knew we was gonna need a clothesline. I knew we were gonna need like certain other things, the toilet, coffee pot, or a percolator. We have both here. We decided to get a coffee pot. But yeah, we're gonna go explore today and see what we can get into, and we'll see you later. All right. So if you're wondering what we use to use the bathroom, and I'm not talking about TT. We have this toilet here. You just put this bag in it that has
little granules
of kind of like kitty litter stuff that soak up any liquids. And then we have a roll of toilet paper you take with you, and then you just find
go
a
utilize
spot.
It. All right, right, guys. Just wanted to throw this out there. This lady right here told me that I couldn't do this by myself. Backing it up, lining it up without anybody doing it, helping me. Just so y'all know, bada boom, bada bing, I did it just fine by myself.
Daisy likes the shade.
Should we go this way?
Yeah. Today I have my hiking shoes on. See the grip? Best hiking shoes ever.
I don't know where this goes. So the experience altogether was good. I think we didn't sleep really well because we made the mistake of letting the dogs get in there with us, and our battery actually wasn't fully charged, so we had we did run out of battery in the middle of the night, so it got a little warm. But the biggest thing was this one right here. She was up and about all night long, and trust me, that won't happen again because she will be sleeping in the Jeep next time. That's not gonna happen. and then the hike, you know, they need some covers for their feet. We were gonna hike into the valley and didn't really get to finish that hike because they kept coming across those little teddy bear cactuses and the little things that fell off of there. Daisy got one real bad in her foot. Veda got a couple of them on her, but nothing major. But it became to where we were dodging them a lot, so I made the call to turn around and for us to wait until we can get some covers for their feet so they can hike with some covers on their feet, so maybe it'll be a little safer for them. As far as the cooking experience was excellent. Everything worked great. Can't complain about that. We used very little water, so we have a 17 or 18 gallon tank and used very little out of it. I mean, the tank is about that tall and we used about that much water. And we weren't super conservative with our water, but we were watching our water, but not to a degree that was, you know, burdensome or anything like that. Altogether, everything went pretty well. The food was good. Company was okay. Company was great. And, you know, everything went smooth. I think the shakedown run was pretty good. We did see some deficiencies in our gear, things that we need and want to pick up to make things better. But I think we'll get those things and we'll adjust and move forward.
We're also going to post the REI camping list on our YouTube channel. So down in the comments, you'll see that PDF file or the website that you can go to. We'll post that. I'm also going to create our own with our stuff on it, so if you want to use that, if you have animals or maybe you have a bean trailer considering getting one, then you might want to look at ours because it's going to be specific for that. So I'm going to create one and create a PDF file or a file that's going to go in the comment section on the YouTube channel. So
If there's anything else that you see in our video today or last night or yesterday that you have questions about, please comment in the bottom and let us know. Ask us questions and we'll try to get those answers to you. So the trailer is pretty good. I mean, we wouldn't take it rock crawling or anything, but that's pretty good on the trail. So I think I have a little more confidence in it. Rock. You have plenty of room on this side. Jesus, protect the bean. Woo! Okay, didn't I say we weren't gonna do rock crawling? We have to get out, though. Oh, God. And we scrubbed. It's a little, that's not a pothole, that's a crater. No, you're good. Stay right there. So, this is what the trailer just went through. Any of y'all that have done Valley of the Moon? Probably know about this section. So, it's very twisty and pretty gnarly for a trailer. So, never thought a teardrop trailer could go off-road like this. So, pretty satisfied.
Watch as I drop out of
it. Oh God. Slow, slow, slow. There you go. Eek!
whole new element driving through stuff with the trailer, because you don't just worry about the line for the Jeep, you also have to worry about the line for the tractor.
Okay guys, this wraps up our overland excursion to the Valley of the Moon, and this was our shakedown run, so we learned a lot, and we hope you stay tuned, because next time we'll be bringing you another adventure in the bean trailer, hopefully soon, and look for that video guys. And until next time, this is Kevin with GrayLine Overland, and I hope to see you out on the trail.
All right, who needs a drone when you can just crawl a bunch of rocks way up here? Just climb up here and get an aerial view. But now I gotta get down, so yeah.